I create reportages about the revolution. So we bring videos together. It's kind of like developed stage in the revolutionary media in Syria. We started with just sending out videos with very bad quality. Then we turned to the better quality videos. Now we are putting videos together, talking about certain topic of our daily lives back in Syria and sending it to the different TV channels. It cannot be worse than this. They are targeted. Well, yesterday a Japanese journalist died there. We all heard about Mari Colvin, and I highly recommend seeing the interviews that were done with Paul Conroy, the journalist who was injured there. Now we are talking about professional journalists who are professional and experts in dealing with war zones, and even though many of them lost their lives, they are being targeted. And in Syria, we have this very unique case where many citizen journalists documented their last minutes on this earth. So you can imagine. Well, now, sadly and unfortunately, I can say that the violence has reached everyone in Syria. You have almost daily indiscriminate shelling all over the country. We are talking about Aleppo, we are talking about Damascus, we all heard about Homs and Hama. We are talking about the eastern part of the country, the western part. The shelling reached every single part of Syria, all the towns, unfortunately, and we are talking about 1 million of displaced people, either internally or outside as refugees. So the humanitarian situation is again extremely severely difficult, and yeah, I think the violence is reaching everyone, unfortunately. I lost friends, and it's very, very sad. I lost both friends on the professional level, the citizen journalists that were working in Syria, and I lost the classmates in Syria. My family is still okay. Yeah, but this is part of our struggle. Unfortunately, we stopped expecting anything some time ago. We tried our best to, mainly the process was to get the picture, the real picture, out of the country, so the international community, the humanity can see what's happening in Syria. So the civil society moves, and the political sphere moves as well in toward certain actions. Now on the political level, well, on the civil level, no one did anything. Though we lost 23,000 of Syrian souls, the civil societies around the world did not do much. On the political level, they implemented some sanctions. But sanctions are not working. We need arms for the Free Syrian Army that is now responsible for liberating the Syrian people. It might not be rosy, and it might seem like supporting one part, but this is life. It's a war, and the Assad regime is the perpetrator in this war. And I believe that it's time. It was time. It's too late already, but time to support the Free Syrian Army. Let me remind you and stress very much on this. We had 6 to 7 months of extreme peacefulness. It was totally non-violent movement, and the struggle, we went out with roses and olive branches. It was one of the most beautiful and pure revolutions. What drove us to here is not our desire for blood, but it's reality, it's logic. We had to do something, we had to protect ourselves. If you slap me 10 times in the face, I will react, I will do something, I will try to stop you at least. And that's what we are trying to do. Simply saving our lives. We asked for freedom and dignity, we were shelled. Now we are protecting ourselves. I find it logical after 7 months of total peacefulness.